now if a hurricane comes, and I've lived through a lot of hurricanes. 69, Camille, Frederick in 79, Ivan and Katrina. And what I saw out of the hurricanes was the communities, we got together and we helped one another. Those who had shared it with the others, and it wasn't, it's when the people lose hope, like Katrina, when the people in New Orleans were drowning, they were isolated on little islands, and they were seeing people die, they lost hope. Then they started looting and ramping and killing each other, and it was a nightmare. I am on the Gulf Coast, Alabama. So we were in direct line of Hurricane Katrina. You know, it was a 300-mile-wide hurricane that came, and we were out of power for weeks. So I said, the first 3 or 4 days of the power out, everybody's eating good because their freezers are thawing and you can't eat it fast enough. 4, 5, 6 days, the grocery stores, all the food went bad in the grocery stores too, and they're not even open. And the only thing people have left is canned goods. And most people don't have a garden. Now, I live out in rural areas, and there are a lot of gardens out here and farmers that grow food. But for the most part, people in the city, they don't. My father, he grew up in the Great Depression here. And when he pulled a nail out of a board, he'd straighten it and put it back in the box. And it's not that he couldn't afford to go to the hardware store. I mean, he could have bought the hardware store. He was just being a good steward of what he had. And so that's kind of my philosophy here is I'm still on grid, but I'm just going to take advantage and use the land and resources that I have till its fullest. When the Great Depression hit here, the people that lived out in the rural areas and the farmers, they didn't feel the depression. They still got up, fed their chickens, gathered the eggs, and plowed their fields. It was just business as usual. It was the people that were dependent on buying their supplies from somebody else that felt the depression. So, you know, our forefathers, they didn't have electricity. They didn't have modern conveniences that we do. So when we lose those, that's going to be hard on us.
It's a beautiful philosophy, and most people have abandoned that philosophy. It's that generation when there was still a shortage and people had to mend things instead of buying new things. Why are we in such a minority now?
Laziness. We like the microwave society where we want it right now. And, you know, I grow a lot of my own fruits and vegetables and nuts and but kids nowadays, they want, you know, a burger from McDonald's. And unfortunately, I can't plan a row of Happy Meals. So they don't like beans. They don't like rice. They don't like cabbage. You know, this is stuff that I grew up on and love it.
You seem to be in a palatial mansion.
We live kind of nice.
Yeah, how big is your house? How many square foot?
Under roof, it's 5,500.
That's big. That is a big.
Yeah, we've had a lot of children, and we take in people, and we've fostered 12 children. I have 2 girls of my own, and then we adopted another girl. So Father's Day and Christmas is pretty big around here.
So there you are in a very substantial-looking home. What have you done to it to make it in order to unplug? What modifications have you made?
Well, I have a lot of land here, and I built my house. I didn't buy it. I laid the foundation from top to bottom. It's God's given me a lot of skills, and it took me years. We actually lived in the barn while we built the house. So this wasn't something I inherited or I hit the jackpot. This was hard work, years. I have about 1,000-watt solar system. I actually build my own solar panels from scrap. I buy the cells and the glass.
But still, that's a lot of rooms to heat and cool and maintain. That's a lot of work. So you must be pretty busy all day just keeping the system ticking over.
Not really. It pretty much runs itself. I heat my water with the sun. It's a totally passive system. When the sun's up and on it, hot water rises through a thermal siphon, rises to the tank, stores the water. I don't have to do anything. And I also have a creek that runs through my property with a man-made dam waterfall. It's only 3 foot, but I built a large 22-inch diameter generator that's designed to turn real slow, not 3,000 RPMs like most. And I charge a bank of batteries, and I'm able to run, like I said, a refrigerator, freezer, some lights. My shop is halfway off grid. I can run skill saws and table saws and drill presses. And the generator is just something that I built from scratch. I start with a bearing from a trailer axle and roll my own stuff, machine it, glue magnets in, do my own wire coils, the stator, the whole spiel. I mean, it's totally a homemade system. I can pretty much keep an eye on my amperage at my batteries at a glance. And I have a little blinking light on my charge controller, and I can see it out my window when I'm brushing my teeth. And I can see, and I kind of know how much energy I have in the battery. And so it's real low maintenance. And my garden is real low maintenance. I mean, I can have the whole thing planted in just an hour.
Amazing. And that doesn't feed you.
I have food year-round here.
But not enough for everybody, obviously. You couldn't do that.
Well, you'd be surprised, because I'll grow, like right now, I have black-eyed peas growing. And I'll grow enough black-eyed, it's summertime, it's hot. And I'll grow enough black-eyed peas out of my garden, and I'll dry them out. I'll get 100 pounds, and that'll be enough for me till this time next year. So we do grow enough. I mean, there's people that live here. I've got another cottage off to the side that I have a lady living in, and we joke and say, you know, she'll say, oh, I'm going to the grocery store. And she walks down to the garden. It's not going down the aisle.
And when are you on America Unplugged? Which date is it?
We're episode 5 on July the 3rd, 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time.